Look at how busy it is here.
Wow.
Get the F out of this town.
We're Jamie and Skylar, and in this episode, we meet the best guard donkey named Jack. Tour our Yurt Airbnb, find the only donut shop near Cosby, Tennessee, drive through Gatlinburg, and hike the Alum Cave Trail in the Great Smoky Mountains National Park. Make sure to watch until the end to see how we end up rewarding ourselves after 3 days of hiking.
We woke up this morning in the yurt and Skylar's getting warm by the heater.
Feels very good.
The cute little coffee pot. I can hear the donkey.
We started the day drinking coffee out of a coffee cup with a picture of the yurt we stayed in.
That's us.
After warming up, we made our way down to our truck and checked out the rest of the property during the day. We had quite an interesting experience arriving to the Airbnb in the dark, so if you're interested in that story, make sure to check out our last vlog hiking in North Carolina. We finally got to meet the donkey we had heard the night before and earlier in the morning.
You're excited, aren't you?
Aww. Made a donkey friend.
That's just how you say hello, huh? It's a loud hello.
It is a loud hello. You're not going to make loud noises when we leave, are you?
Yes.
Yes, I definitely am. See you later. Oh, this is Donkey Jack.
Oh.
And Goat Corazon. Hi, Jack. Wanted to come say hi to us again? You can see our yurt is there. There it is.
It is worth mentioning that the rental property is set up for small events like weddings as well.
All right, are you ready for the yurt tour? On the right, we have our outhouse, and there is a compost toilet in there. We also have a nice view from the toilet. And there are additional bathrooms further down on the property if you want to walk a bit. But it was nice to have the outhouse right outside of the yurt. Okay, let's go in. And here it is.
If you're interested in staying in this yurt Airbnb, we'll leave the link to the listing and the rentals website in the description below.
All right, here's the tour. There's a nice comfy bed that we slept in last night. And we did have a space heater because it got chilly. So we were thankful that that was here. And there's even a nice little refrigerator so we could chill some beers we enjoyed last night. And there's also a coffee pot so we enjoyed some coffee this morning. There's a nice little table. We didn't do any eating here, but we could. And here's the view, just one of the views. Where this property is located is in a valley, so it's surrounded by mountains on all sides. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but there's got to be a river nearby because you can hear water rushing. So overall, it was a very peaceful place to stay in. Great way to unplug. This is probably one of the most unique places we've stayed so far. We definitely agree with this. I think we'll be climbing another mountain today. Oh, are you sad to leave the yurt?
No. I'm ready for more hiking.
Oh. I could use some more relaxation.
Well, that's nice.
Yeah.
So here's where we would have loved to have shown you some drone footage of the property that this yurt is on. Skylar got the drone out yesterday and discovered that it was flying sideways because it had a bent propeller. And of course, what did we not bring along with us? Extra propellers. So unfortunately, we don't have any drone footage for you. Donkey Jack is excited again. This time it's not us.
Jack walked over again to tell us goodbye. See you next time. Bye. He's watching us walk away.
If you're new to our channel, we invite you to subscribe to follow along on more of our adventures.
We're leaving the valley where we stayed in the yurt. We would definitely recommend it if you're looking for a place to unplug and just enjoy nature.
And since we are surrounded by mountains, we had no cell phone service whatsoever, which was awesome, but we are really thankful we took the time to download the maps off of Google for the area. So that way, even though we didn't have cell phone reception, all we had to do was plug in the GPS coordinates for our next destination, and we're on our way.
After leaving the Hot Springs area, we crossed the border into Tennessee to visit the Smoky Mountains National Park.
We are on the Foothills Parkway heading west about a mile east of Cosby, Tennessee. And this is the view that you can get just from the side of the road.
Skylar promised me donuts and we were expecting a donut shop. Got this sign, so let's go eat a donut.
The little donut shop was the only donut shop we found between Hot Springs, North Carolina and Cosby, Tennessee.
These are the healthy kind of donuts, right?
Sure!
One of them will go. Yeah.
So if you are in Cosby, Tennessee and looking for donuts, you want to stop by the general store. And they will make the donuts fresh for you. While you can get these delicious fresh donuts in Cosby, there is not a coffee shop, so we are settling for these.
All right, so we're currently just entering Gatlinburg city limits. You can definitely tell the traffic's starting to pick up, as we were told it would. The drive from Cosby, Tennessee to Gatlinburg, that 20 miles or so, was probably my favorite part of the drive yet. A little bit curvy, but not nearly as curvy as some of the roads we've been on before, and it's just an easy drive, which I'm really appreciating right now after driving on all of those super bumpy, narrow, curvy roads in North Carolina.
The enjoyable drive was about to change. The traffic slowed us down quite a bit as we got into Gatlinburg.
We've been stopped at the same traffic light for maybe 10 minutes. It's like been the third round of the traffic light and we still haven't made it through.
Better keep going.
This might be really exciting. I think we're gonna make it through. Yes. Yes, we finally made it through. Oh my gosh.
15 minutes.
Look at how busy it is here. Wow.
We need to get the F out of this town.
Okay, I really get why everybody told us, like, oh, Gatlinburg, there's going to be people everywhere. They're right. If you were staying here, though, and just had to walk around, it wouldn't be near as bad. Driving, takes a long time.
Finally out of Gatlinburg and back in the woods. I think my blood pressure has returned to normal levels.
Skylar is happy again. Gosh, there's still so many cars out here.
Still way too many cars, yes, but
we are here during a pretty popular time with the leaves changing color.
We just went into the national park.
Sweet.
Today has been much slower going than our last few days, if you haven't noticed. This morning we actually got up early at the yurt, but for some reason we didn't leave there until after 10, and I'm not even sure what we were doing, why it took us that long.
Well, I was waiting for you and hanging out with the donkey.
Well, I don't even know what I was doing, but I was moving really slow. And then on the way to get the donuts, right after we got the donuts, there was a wreck on the highway and they weren't letting cars pass on either side. So we just had to wait for that. And then driving through Gatlinburg, that took way more time than we expected. And now that we're in the forest, it looks like there's another wreck. So traffic is just slow, slow moving.
Yeah, and the speed limit in this park is like 15, 20 miles per hour. So I don't even understand how you get in a wreck.
I don't know. But the good thing about all these setbacks today is that when we finally do get on the trails, I think we're really going to appreciate it.
That's true.
Even though the drive was slow, the scenery was beautiful, and we're glad that we visited. If you're interested in areas to hike that aren't quite as crowded, make sure to watch our vlog series from the beginning. We spend time in Chimney Rock State Park and the Lindell Gorge Wilderness in North Carolina. When we got close to the trailhead, we couldn't believe all the cars parked on the side of the road.
What are you doing?
Just enjoying being parked and off the road. Ready for this hike.
Yeah, I think when people told us it was going to be busy, I didn't think it was going to be this busy.
Yeah, that was a long, slow drive. Hopefully the trails will not be as busy as the roads.
We're here. We parked. I know Skylar's itinerary had us here before noon. It's now about 2, so we're gonna get on the trails.
In this video, we'll be sharing highlights from the Alum Cave Trail. If you want more information about the trail or wanna see the full hike, make sure to watch our Alum Cave Trail full hike video.
So we are here, and the plan is to hike all along this area up to the cave bluff. You can keep going, but we got such a late start, I don't think that's something we're gonna consider today. Stairs eventually lead to this.
We did end up hiking a bit past the Alum Cave Bluffs.
We're finding this trail to be quite diverse. It starts out pretty flat along the river, and then it changes, and you go up in elevation, and you end up climbing on some rocks. I should say hiking, not really climbing. But a lot of different types of terrain.
We made it to the bluff area and hiked probably about a half mile past that. We talked to some hikers along the way and they encouraged us to take the trail all the way to the top, but unfortunately we just don't have that much time today, so that will have to wait for another trip. We're gonna sit down and have a snack and then hike our way back to the car.
Skylar went exploring while I stuck to the stairs. Oh look, here he comes behind me. We just left Inspiration Point on the way back down, and it's a really cool view with all of the leaves changing color right now, so we would recommend that viewpoint.
So are you inspired to get back to the car now?
I think so. I'm ready for some food.
Yeah, I'm definitely ready for a real meal.
Yeah, the other days when we went hiking, we went so long that we didn't even have time to go to a sit-down restaurant. We had to do all drive-throughs, so maybe tonight we'll get a good meal.
Hopefully.
As we left the Great Smoky Mountains National Park, we did get to see the sunset.
dark and we are not yet to our next Airbnb, but we're really close. This time we're staying on a Native American reservation. We're excited to see the third Airbnb that we're gonna stay in on this trip. Sorry, this is our first establishment after hiking for 3 days. We really just drank that beer fast. I didn't get to show it to you before we drank most of it. We have been eating beef jerky and fast food for the last several days. I have not been more excited to have Mexican food ever. I don't think Skylar has been this happy to eat a burrito ever. That thing is giant. Clearly we were hungry. I really can't believe Skylar ate that whole burrito.
I can.
Tonight we're staying at an Airbnb in somebody's home. We have got a huge bed over there. And a little fire. I think this is the first one we're staying in that has a television.
It is.
I don't know if we're going to use it though. Oh gosh, but we are tired, so we're going to go to bed.
Thanks so much for watching the whole episode. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give it a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and share it with your friends. If you're new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications on. In our next vlog episode, we visit Soco Falls, spend time in Cashers, North Carolina, and hike on Whiteside Mountain. You won't want to miss it. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next time.